proceedings. It should be thrown out. Do you understand? That's one way to beat your traffic ticket. To make sure the court has the jurisdiction. If there is no personal injury, the court doesn't have any standing for jurisdiction. Therefore, you cannot proceed. There you have it. You should beat that ticket. Another way to try and beat the ticket is to have the policeman, not officer, impeach as a witness. Now, what do I mean by that? To have the policeman impeach. That doesn't mean to have him thrown out of office, but to have his voice as a witness not heard. Now, how are we going to do this? You're going to question him. You're going to question him. Usually the policeman is represented by a lawyer, maybe even two in traffic court. You're going to question him or you're going to address him in the court. They usually allow you to question him. They don't like it because they're aware that, hey, well, this person might be onto something. He's not just coming in here and just paying his fines, because traffic court is set up in a manner in which they make the fees low enough so that you could pay him. You pay him off so they keep getting the money in. It's a big scam, brothers and sisters. So what you're going to do is question this policeman. And again, remember, recall that a plaintiff must allege personal injury. Allen versus Wright, 468, U.S. 737-751, United States Supreme Court. So, as everyone else, the policeman is required to file what is known as a cause of action. So you're going to ask this policeman two questions, because you want him impeached. If he's impeached, then that means his ticket or suit, because a ticket is a lawsuit against you. I hope you understand that. That means that they're suing you. So his ticket, if he is impeached, then his ticket is impeached with him. And you're relieved of that. So his testimony is impeached, so is his ticket. It's taken out of the court. Now, the first question that you're going to answer this, that you're going to ask this policeman is, did you file a valid cause of action? Did you file a valid cause of action? He has to say yes, because there has to be a valid cause of action. So you're going to ask him, did you file a valid cause of action? He's going to say yes. His lawyer usually let him enter that. He's going to say yes. Otherwise, what? There's not going to be any standing. Now, the next question that you're going to ask him, that you're going to ask this policeman, and his lawyer, or his two lawyers, usually probably just jump up and start screaming objection, and the plaintiff is incapable or incompetent to answer that question. And the second question is, how many elements are there in a valid cause of action that will usually set his lawyer off and say that he's incapable of or incompetent to answer that question? It won't get the case thrown out, but he should be impeached. And if he's impeached, because his lawyers are not going to let him answer that question. Once again, the second question was, how many elements are in a valid cause of action? That's it. More than likely, they're going to, his lawyer is going to state the plaintiff is incompetent to answer this question. And the judge is going to, the judge will usually sustain the objection when the lawyer objects. And the testimony should be stricken from the record. And the police should be impeached. And lastly, what I wanted to point out is, if you really think that you're going to get a fair trial in traffic court, then you're totally deceived. That's just deceptive thinking. You're not going to get a fair trial in traffic court, even though that they tell you and they have all these little slogans and so on and so forth that everyone's entitled to a fair trial. It's impossible to get a fair trial in traffic court. Why? Because there's a conflict of interest. Why do you say that? Why are you saying that, Talada? There's a conflict of interest. And you could this could be established by directing your questions towards the judge. The first question that you're going to answer the judge, you're going to ask the judge three questions. One, am I entitled to a fair trial? He's going to answer yes. He doesn't have a problem answering that. But judges don't like to ask questions because they think you know something. So you're going to ask him, am I entitled to a fair trial? He's going to say yes. And then you're going to ask him, can I get a fair trial if there's a conflict of interest? He's going to say no, because he knows it's impossible to get a fair trial if there's a conflict of interest. So the last question that you're going to ask him, you're going to say to the judge, well, who do you represent here? Who are you representing? Chances are he's not going to answer that, because that creates a conflict of interest. Why? Because the judge is representing the state. So if the judge is representing the state, how can you get a fair trial? It's impossible. You see, it's set up for you to lose. It's set up for you to lose, brothers and sisters. Do you follow me? And that's what I wanted to bring up. So hopefully, you know, you could use this to your advantage. And if it helps you, then pass it along unto another brother or sister. Once again, my name is Tazadok, and I say Shalom. Shalom, Yasha Allah.